other day I was ricocheting slowly off the blue walls of this room, moving as if underwater from typewriter to piano, from bookshelf to an envelope lying on the floor, when I found myself in the L section of a dictionary, where my eyes fell upon the word lanyard. No cookie nibbled by a French novelist could send one into the past more suddenly. A past where I sat at a workbench at a camp by a deep Adirondack lake, learning how to braid long, thin plastic strips into a lanyard, a gift from my mother. I had never seen anyone use a lanyard, or wear one, if that's what you did with them, but that did not keep me from crossing strand over strand again and again until I had made a boxy red and white lanyard for my mother. She gave me life and milk from her breasts, and I gave her a lanyard. She nursed me in many a sick room, lifted spoons of medicine to my lips, laid cold face cloths on my forehead, and then led me out into the airy light and taught me to walk and swim, and I in turn presented her with a lanyard. "Here are thousands of meals," she said, "and here is clothing and a good education." "And here is your lanyard," I replied, which I made with a little help from a counselor. "Here is a breathing body and a beating heart, strong legs, bones, and teeth, and two clear eyes to read the world," she whispered. "And here," I said, "is the lanyard I made at camp." And here I wish to say to her now is a smaller gift, not the worn truth that you can never repay your mother, but the rueful admission that when she took the two-tone lanyard from my hand, I was sure as a kid could be that this useless, worthless thing I wove out of boredom would be enough to make us even.
To the sounds of the music of living, happy songs from the laughter of children at play. Take my hand as we run to the sweet fragrant meadows, make memories of what was to be. Have this moment to hold in our hands and to touch as it slips through our fingers like sand. Yesterday's gone and tomorrow may never come, but we have this moment today.
You hear that tiny voice? It's my not-so-tiny daughter who's still calling for me to stop and listen to what she has to say.
And my little son, running there down that hillside, never be quite like today.
We have this moment to hold in our hands and to touch as it slips through our fingers like sand. Yesterday's gone and but we have this moment today.